Your mind is going to be blown when we start talking about some of the jobs that don't exist today, but will in the future. Now, these are jobs that you might think, oh, that will never happen in my lifetime, or oh, that is so far out from the future. As we've seen, even since the release of ChatGPT, how many more AI-generated tools have come out, how far we have gotten with media and video and generated art coming out, it's going to be in your lifetime. Or if not in your lifetime, very close after, in my opinion. Maybe I'm an opportune, no, what is the word? An optimist thinking that tech is evolving, but tech is, according to research, evolving at a very quick rate, quicker than it was even a few years ago, and that is continuing to speed up. So naturally, I'm curious to hear if you think these jobs will be around in our lifetime, your lifetime, my lifetime, depending on the age. These are some future jobs that are speculative, of course, and I got them through talking to ChatGPT, through looking online, and just hearing what some experts are saying. Let's jump into it. Oh, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, give this video a like, comment down below, what are some of the wildest jobs that don't exist today that you think will in the future? Let's get into it. First on the list is cybersecurity human security officer. Why would cybersecurity need human officers or human chief officers? Well, for the reason of, as we become closer to more implants, more chips getting used in humans, we will need someone to maintain that and ensure things don't go, well, frankly, sideways. Having a cybersecurity specialist for humans that have chips in them or different tools in them is going to be needed, because the reality is, with this also comes the ability for hackers to hack into humans. This sounds so strange as I say it out loud. But yes, this is something that might potentially be needed in the future if we end up going the way that Elon Musk and others are really pushing for with implanting chips in our brain. Once again, I feel like I'm such a crazy person for making this video, but it's so fascinating thinking about what the implications are, what the pros are. So many pros, having access to AI information right in our brains and 24/7, I'm sure there'll be more geniuses, so many more innovations. But on the flip side, it does come with the risk of having technology part of us and the ability to be hacked. Cybersecurity human specialist officer. That is a title. Next up is one that if you've watched my short form videos, you've heard me talk about, which is space tourism guide. This one gets me really excited. I would love to be a space tourism guide, with different companies like SpaceX and Blue Origin making specifically really large improvements in the world of space when it comes to getting normal citizens to be able to go into space and putting normal citizens into space. That will continue to grow and evolve at a quick rate. And now, this isn't something that's the future, this is happening now. But having a tourism guide where you can imagine people are loading onto a spacecraft, going into space, and the tourism guide can guide them along their journey. That's pretty cool if you ask me. And we're definitely making steps to go in that direction, so I'm really curious to see how that one evolves. Next one on the list comes from ChatGPT, and I kind of think it already exists, but let me know your thoughts, which is augmented reality architect. So essentially what it says this person will do is, it will be another rapidly evolving technology that has the potential to create new job opportunities. An AR reality architect could design and create AR experiences that blend the virtual and physical world. I feel like that's already here today, but I've seen this trend over and over again after really diving into future tech topics recently, of AR and the possibilities it brings to us in our daily lives. So I definitely think there is a lot of opportunity in the world of AR, and it looks like ChatGPT does too. Who's smarter, Tiff or ChatGPT? That's the real question. Next on the list is smart city data analyst. This individual is someone who is able to look at a city as a whole, similar to when you think of city planners nowadays, but for smart cities. Smart cities are happening today already. You see, especially in areas, I know Dubai has a lot of features around smart cities. I know there are so many others that I'll list here that I'm missing, but there are so many smart cities that are continuing to pop up or trying to evolve as smart cities as much as possible. And with that comes a lot of data that is going to be collected. The reality is, as everything is automated and technology is intertwined further in these cities, data analysts or companies have the ability to frankly track what's going on, where humans are going, what are they doing, what decisions are they making. Now, that on its own is a whole other topic we are not going to get into in this video, But the reality is, just like companies have data analysts to analyze how people are using their products or their apps and what data they can gather, there is the possibility of data analysts specific for smart cities. This is a really interesting job, if you ask me, or could be an interesting job, merging both city planners, architects, but then also to technologists. Actually, let me pause in some of these updates here. I really want to highlight one thing. We're talking about jobs of the future, and for the most part, they all are really closely intertwined with tech. Do you notice a trend here? Although there are a lot of conversations happening online right now around how tech is going to become obsolete, or tech workers are going to become obsolete, or should you even learn how to code more? Everything I just listed, I think, well, maybe not space tour guide, but for the most part, everything I've listed, you need to be pretty technical or understanding of tech or passionate or be involved in tech to some degree. And I think that will become closer and closer or closely knit together as technology continues to evolve in our daily lives. The need for people who understand technology, understand code, even if they're not coders per se, but understand how tech is built and how it operates is going to become more and more in demand. That's just my personal take based on the way things are going and what we have seen thus far. So I guess the point of that ramble is, if you are worried about should you still break into tech or should you learn how to code, now is a better time than ever, if you ask me. I know the job market is not ideal now, we're not going to cover that, but if you are looking long term, I think now's the time. Actually, this is completely impromptu, but I was just doing a video on this extension for ChatGPT, and I just thought, why not add it in this video? Speaking of future tech, let me show you. Okay, you can see my screen here. This is very candid, I'm doing this. And I just installed this plugin. It's called Genie by OpenAI. It's open source. And what it does is it gives you some shortcuts for your code. So you can see here, there is test, find problems, optimize, explain, complete code. So what I have here is a super, super simple script. It's really basic. But even if you do something where it's like, let's do add tests, and then you can see here how quickly it is generating the test. This isn't sponsored or anything. I just found this plugin I thought was really cool. And it's connected right to OpenAI. I had to put an API key in from OpenAI to use it. And so that's how fast it just generated some tests. You can also do, say I wanna understand these tests, I guess, maybe. So highlight it and then go down to explain. And then it should explain. This code is a unit test. Oh, it's not focusing very well. But anyways, it explains the code. So anyways, it's called Genie AP or Genie extension for VS Code. Completely free from my understanding of just installing it and playing around with it. And yeah, if you want to check it out. Last on the list I really want to talk about is climate reverse specialist. And this kind of already is starting to pop up now as climate continues to become such an important topic of discussion. And what climate reverse specialist will do, according to online, is someone who is using technology, using this data to find ways to, if not reverse the climate and what we have done thus far to it, at least protect it moving forward. And tech is going to be an integral part of that, from understanding the data, finding new ways with technology to build better tech, to build better ways to live that aren't having such a negative impact on our climate. All right, I need to sit down here. Those are some areas, some future jobs that don't necessarily exist today, but potentially will in the future. And I really wanted to make this video because I've done some short form content on jobs of the future, and I think it's fascinating just to even start thinking or looking up some potential jobs. For the reason of, I don't know about you, but I always like to know potentially where I could, things I could get into, things of interest. I'm just trying to understand what the future holds. And I think based on patterns and data of how tech has evolved thus far, we have a pretty good sense of where and when it will evolve. And these roles, honestly, if you would have told me a few years about them, I would have thought, you're crazy. There's no way these are going to be a thing. And now, living in today, I'm like, of course, a lot of these make a lot of sense. So I'm curious to hear, what do you think are some jobs of the future? What are some skills you will need for these jobs? Data seems to be a big trend, cybersecurity. There's different trends in each of these jobs that are still coming through. The reality is though, once again, if you're just starting out and want to know where to begin, I would just start out immersing yourself in technology, whether it be in a specific area, or maybe you don't know a specific area of interest yet, I would just start out learning some code or speaking to people in the industry. Anyways, leave down below other jobs you think will be coming out of tech in the next few years. And that was very slow. Editor, can you speed that up? I'll see you all soon. Bye, everyone.